NovaCustom sent me this laptop to review. It has 96 gigs of RAM, almost as much base storage as some iPhones. It runs Cubes, as you can tell, and it can run Linux. It has countless customizations that are rare to find, and they even offer nifty features like coreboot and disabling Intel ME for extra peace of mind. Let's take a look at this laptop and see what it's all about. Before getting into the software, let's talk hardware. It comes with an Intel Core Ultra 7 155H with an iGPU. You can upgrade this to an NVIDIA 4060 and 4070. I have 96 gigs of RAM, DDR5. No big deal, I guess, but you can do far cheaper if you want to have less RAM. They sent me this laptop with Cubes, which eats RAM like nobody's business, making it a great machine for Cubes. But mind you, you don't need 96 gigs of RAM to run Cubes, so feel free to get less RAM if you need. It has an M2 2TB SSD. I still have an open slot, but you can fill both up if you desire. It comes with Wi-Fi 6E and Bluetooth 5.3, or they now have a Wi-Fi 7 plus Bluetooth 5.42 card if you want something a little bit newer. You can choose no Wi-Fi card if you want this laptop to be radio free. We'll talk about that more in the privacy section. 16-inch Quad HD 2560 by 1600, which is an upgrade from the regular 1080p. I would personally opt for the 14-inch model, as the 16-inch is a bit too large for my tastes, but we'll talk about why they sent a 16-inch model in the software section. Teaser, it has to do with Cubes. Battery life is about, in my experience, 5 hours on Cubes with the 16-inch model, but you can probably get another 1 to 2 hours with a regular OS. They also ship with countless power cords, regardless of where you live. The I/O I really enjoy. There is a charging port, a Thunderbolt, one USB-C, two USB-A, and a headphone jack. But if you turn it around, you have a surprise on the back with Ethernet and HDMI. The trackpad is fine, could be better, could be worse. That's how I feel about most PC trackpads. I would probably carry around a mouse most places I go. There are global keyboard options and, thank God, custom super keys, so you don't have to look at a Windows logo on a Windows laptop, which I'm sure many of us are too familiar with. I just stumbled on Reddit organically how they did this. They didn't tell me, which they should have, because it's pretty freaking cool. So repairability is pretty solid. If you open it up, obviously you have the battery pack. We have RAM here, which you can easily just pop off and replace. And you have the Wi-Fi card here, which you can manually remove on your end if you'd like to do that after the fact and you change your mind. And of course, we have the NVMe here. And I believe over here is the open M.2 slot that you can also use. Nothing too crazy for what you're probably used to with most PCs, but of course, coming from a MacBook or even some more modern PCs nowadays, things are beginning to be soldered, so it's nice to see just open repairability by just removing the back. Build quality, not the best in the world. This feels a bit clunky compared to a MacBook Pro, but I think a more fair comparison would be a NovaCustom versus other privacy and security-oriented laptops, which typically have traditionally been ThinkPads. And if that's your comparison, then I actually think this is great. When you put it together, it is a fairly nice piece of hardware. I can't really complain about this, and I am overall very impressed with the repairability and, of course, the customization and the kind of performance that you can squeeze out of a solid machine. So, good stuff. Let's start with the elephant in the room. QubesOS. The 16-inch version of this laptop is certified Cubes compatible with a nice display, which is quite pleasant to use, to the point where I don't think a non-tech-savvy user would be able to tell that these are practically VMs. I also think pre-installing Cubes removes half the battle of actually using it. And at the time of publishing this review, the 14-inch is Cubes certified, so I would definitely hop on that if you prefer a smaller form factor like myself. Now, if you don't want Cubes, they have every possible option when configuring the laptop, including just no OS, so you can flash anything yourself, which is personally what I would opt to do. But for those of you paying attention, there's a much more underrated part of this laptop. These can all ship with coreboot, open source firmware designed to be far more transparent and secure than the typical firmware you'd find on most computers today. This isn't something people tend to generally think about since firmware is pretty boring compared to operating systems, but this is probably my favorite thing about the laptop. From there, they can configure full disk encryption out of the box, and I know a lot of people will love the fact that Intel Management Engine can be disabled on this device if you choose. You can actually enable and disable it yourself just in the core boot menu if you change your mind. The last note on software is their customization comes through again by allowing you to easily change things like the boot screen when configuring the laptop, which I think is quite pleasant for obvious reasons. Now, besides what I've already shared, the rest of the software story depends on which OS you choose to run. So make sure that you're picking an OS that you feel is best for you, or else this system isn't going to be good. I think QubesOS is a wonderful concept, but I don't love its day-to-day use. I'll be doing a dedicated review for my full thoughts on Cubes, so subscribe to see that. Speaking of QubesOS and privacy and security, do you know what's compatible with this system? Notesnook, the encrypted notes provider and sponsor of this video. Notesnook is an end-to-end encrypted notes provider so that you can store your thoughts, ideas, and anything else that is sensitive to you in the cloud without anybody else being able to read what you're doing. Running Notesnook on a hardcore system like this really is no biggie, as it's supported on both Linux and in the web. They're open source, and I think the community behind it is phenomenal. You can even go ahead and join their Discord server if you want to ask the developer behind it any questions. Coming from someone who's tried Obsidian and Notion and all of these other tools, Notesnook actually still has a lot of the same functionality that you would see in those other tools. Regardless of what OS you're on, if you're somebody who values your notes and ideas and wants to keep them to yourself away from spying eyes, Notesnook is a phenomenal service, and it's free to try and it's open source. And I'll leave a link down in the description for any of you to go check it out. Now back to the laptop to touch on privacy and security. So let me kind of go through the facts. The 16-inch laptop is Cube certified, and you can either have it pre-installed or you can install it yourself. You can also run almost any other Linux distro on it. It comes with coreboot, open source firmware, which you can also deploy with heads for even more security. You should be able to do this yourself after the fact, but keep in mind, it's a Cubes only thing for advanced users. You can disable Intel ME yourself with coreboot, or you have the option to have them disable it for you. They can do full disk encryption for you, or of course, you can always do it yourself. They will remove the camera and mic modules permanently if you ask them to, and won't even ship with them. They can pre-install a privacy screen. There's a Kensington lock port if you wanted to lock the laptop physically. They can ship the laptop with a bus kill, which is a dead man switch that we've covered in a different review. I highly recommend checking that out. And they can use tamper evident screws and packaging if you want more peace of mind that the laptop that they send from their office hasn't been tampered with by anyone on its way to you. I did an interview with Wessel from NovaCustom that will come out shortly when he explains how they do this with nail polish, which I thought was a cool detail because I've never really heard of these precautions before. Now, apart from the laptop itself, it's good to look at incidents like the cryptocurrency wallet Ledger's data breach. The hardware wallets may be secure, but the data breach exposed user info for practically everyone who purchased it, which was a disaster for users concerned about being targeted for purchasing a security device. As for NovaCustom, I think they do a pretty good job of trying to mitigate this as best they can because they support Bitcoin and Monero for max privacy. You'll also need a private way of receiving the laptop. But for those of you who follow us, you've probably already heard how you can do this in things like our interview with Jonathan Steele, who talked about this. Another kind of subtle pro tip is you can pick up a NovaCustom laptop yourself in the Netherlands to avoid shipping altogether. So yeah, lots of good stuff. And just for fun, if you want the max security Techlore configuration of this laptop, I would buy the 16-inch laptop without an OS, which you would use to install Cubes and full disk encryption later, buy it without a Wi-Fi card, without cameras and mics, get coreboot with heads, disable Intel ME to reduce attack surface, get a privacy screen with the tamper-evident screws, and be sure to buy it using a VPN or Tor with Monero and an email alias, and then ship it to a private address or pick it up at their office in the Netherlands. Though I wouldn't recommend this to most people, as it's a very extreme threat model. Now you might be saying, I can do this all on my own. And I think that's great, I can too. But I also think it shouldn't be a requirement for someone to be technical to get access to good security tools. What NovaCustom's doing, I think, is pretty unique because it's taking otherwise niche security tools and making them accessible to anybody. Massive props to them. So if you were to ask me what I love about this laptop, first, customizability. It's like building a desktop, but in a laptop form factor. Coreboot, heads, no Wi-Fi card, the level of control is pretty good. Second, they make cubes easy to install and use, and not just for cubes, but really any OS. Third, they're privacy focused, from the payment options to the tamper evident screws. I think they make it pretty clear that they care about privacy. Fourth, their cost is in the ballpark of their competitors. And while you can definitely find a better value machine, I think it's hard to find a machine with better privacy, security, and customization at this price point. It's just hard to find. Now, if you were to ask me what I don't love, first, the build quality isn't as premium as what I'm used to. It's not terrible and is pretty solid for PC standards, but I think if you're expecting MacBook Pro quality, you're just not gonna find it here. Second, the 16-inch model, like I said, is a bit bulky for me. The battery life is good, but not great. Keep in mind, I'm used to the MacBook Pro, which can literally play a YouTube video for over 24 hours on a single charge, and this won't come near that. So who's this laptop for and not for? To start with for, I think privacy and security conscious users, for that, laptop's solid. I also think the combination of various security features I outlined make this useful for researchers, journalists, dissidents, and anyone else in a position where they want the strongest protections out there. And the third main option for the for is enthusiasts who want a personalized laptop. NovaCustom gives you that control over your OS and your hardware so you can create a laptop that's pretty much your own. Now, who's this laptop not for? One, if you're someone who doesn't want customization and doesn't feel you need the niche privacy and security features, you can probably find a better value laptop elsewhere. And of course, the second group is people who prioritize aesthetics over functionality. While I don't think it's a bad looking system, there are just much slicker laptops out there. I'd say NovaCustom is more about function over form, so keep that in mind if you're someone who really prefers the aesthetic of things. Overall, putting it together, these are fantastic machines. They really impressed me. I didn't have the highest expectations, and this, along with the other privacy and security focused companies, pre-installing Linux on laptops, making it accessible, putting it in the hands of people, and getting them used to Linux, I really think are the future of Linux. To learn more about the laptops, you can always visit their site, and they have a forum too where you can ask questions. Stay subscribed to catch my interview with Wessel behind NovaCustom, as well as my dedicated Cubes review. Both of those will come out hopefully in the next few weeks, so stay subscribed for those. And I also want to definitely thank NovaCustom for sending this review unit to make this review possible and agreeing to our terms to an independent review. I also want to thank Notesnook and redact.dev for sponsoring our content. Notesnook being the open source end-to-end encrypted notes provider, and Redact is a tool for you to delete all of your posts on various places like Twitter and Reddit automatically. And of course, I want to thank our amazing patrons for supporting our work. Join our Patreon down below to support what we do and gain access to our private Signal group to mingle with others in our community. Finally, check out the top 10 privacy tools I use every day right here. Cubes is not in there, but there are some other cool things in there. I don't think any of them I touched on in this video. Normally I can say there was something I touched on in this video, but not this time. Yeah. See you next time on Techlore.